Yeah, three African players emerge as the top scorers in the English Premier League that just ended. These three players shared the title with 22 goals each, starting with Arsenal's Aubameyang, Pierre, and of course, Liverpool's duo of Mohamed Salah and Mane. Yeah, the three African players had to share the title of being the top scorer in English football. And that makes it for Arsenal, the 12th Arsenal player to have won the top scorer in the season. Not forgetting players like Thierry Henry won it several times, and Ian Wright, of course, did won it. Van Persie also won it as top scorers, and right now it is Pierre Aubameyang. So that's really great to see that Arsenal players are winning the top scorers award. But what is still missing now is going now into the 15th or the 16th season, Arsenal are yet to be crowned as English champions. So what's the problem? Why is this really happening? We will have to wait to see when the tide will turn around. And also for Liverpool, it's a shame to see that two of their players won the top scorers award, sharing 22 goals apiece among each other. And that is massive to for any team to have produced two top scorers and yet not been able to win the title. But the good thing here is that it's interesting to see that African players are really turning their strides up in the English Premier League. And so the question is, why, despite the performance of the African players in the English Premier League, we have yet to see any African team really stepping up in the world stage? The highest they've gone through in the World Cup, it's always the quarterfinal stage. So what's the really problem? Okay, joining me to answer this question, I'd like to link up with Mr. Ivan Musto. Ivan, three African players won the EPL top scorer of the season. What does this really mean to African players and to the continent at large?
It means huge. This is a huge boost for African football. In the last few years, we have seen great talent, great potential from African players, African teams, but unfortunately they have failed in the previous FIFA World Cups. And I'm still wondering why, what does it take for an African team to win the FIFA World Cup? Because they got so much talent. It's just putting all the talent together, manage the talent well, and of course let the federation manage and make sure that the team can play together and a collective group can actually win the FIFA World Cup. So this is huge. The best talent in world football comes from Africa right now, because Messi, Ronaldo are declining, so Salah, Mane, and Aubameyang and other African stars are rising. So I believe this is a great boost, and African football has a great future ahead of them. And I believe strongly that an African team will finally finish and the drought and win the FIFA World Cup in the next future editions.
Okay, well, you've heard it from Ivan Musto. He has given his own thoughts. What's your reaction? What's your thought? What do you think about the African players in the EPL? What do you think about the African players emerging as the trial of them, Aubameyang, Mane, and Mo Salah as the joint top scorers for the EPL? You can drop your comment on the comment box below. Okay, well, it's interesting to see that the English Premier League has come to an end, and so we will be looking forward to see what happens next season. Well, Manchester City has emerged the champion, back-to-back winners, and Pep Guardiola's side will definitely be in the celebration mood. They've of course, they still have a chance to win the treble, having won the Carling Cup and having won the EPL. They're still going for the FA Cup finals, where they will be taking on Watford. So we wish and hope to see them win the treble, and that shows that they are gradually becoming a dominant force in the English Premier League. Okay, well, thank you very much for being part of the Sports Locker with Ken Gaddafi on this occasion. And don't forget, hit the like button and, of course, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you and see you again soon.